I'm Alison Milton. I'm a maker. I specialise in making reproductions of historic artefacts for museums, re-enactors and living historians. One of the things I specialise in is spinning, turning wool into yarn, as they would have done in medieval times, using a spindle and distaff. I've got two sorts of fleeces here. One of them has nice long staple, which means the fibres in it are quite long, and it's well suited to making what's called worsted yarn, which is where all the fibres lie parallel and it makes a beautiful smooth yarn. And that's done by combing the fibres. I've got some prepared locks and you put them onto the tines of the comb and then you take one comb in your left hand, the other comb in your right hand. The first movement is an up and down movement and it's called jigging and it starts combing the fibres out. Once all the fibres have moved from one comb to the other, we reverse the movement and comb them back onto the first comb. We go through this a couple of times until the fibres resemble Santa's beard, a beautiful long waterfall of fibres. Once that's ready, we can start drawing them off. So then I put the comb down and start drawing off what's called a sleever of fibres, which is a long, soft sausage of fibres with all the hairs going in all the same direction. As I take it off, I give it a bit of twist so that it doesn't keep coming to pieces in the breeze. And later on, I'll dress it onto a distaff. The other method of preparing fibres is called carding. And here, I take the fibres and I card them on the paddles, which are called carders. And it makes a web of slightly tangled fibres. They crisscross each other. They're nice and orderly, but they crisscross each other. I've taken the sleever that we combed off earlier, and I'm just dressing it onto the distaff. I then take a spindle, which I use to put twist into the fibres, and as the spindle spins, I draw out the fibres from the sleever and allow the twist from the spindle to run up into the yarn that I'm making, so that they go from being loose fibres that can be pulled apart to becoming proper yarn. When the spindle reaches the floor, I pick it up and then wind it onto the spindle like this, and then redo the little half-hitch knot, which is all that stops the spindle from dropping off. And then, of course, I start spinning again. Spinning's a continuous process. I could keep this up all day. And in fact, in medieval times, most women did. They would spin all the time when they weren't busy doing something else, which is why a distaff is so handy, because it means that your fibres are portable and you can take them with you as you walk to market or go out and chase the sheep out of the cabbages. Once the spindle is full, obviously I need to take the yarn off. And the easiest thing to do with it is to take it off and wind it onto a skein winder, which makes a nice big loop of yarn, which can be tied securely so that it doesn't come unwound and doesn't tangle. And then it can be stored. It's best not to wind it into a ball at this stage because it stretches the yarn.